mess with the zip lining. there's a video that I put together of our zip lining on the videos page at the bottom. I put it at the bottom because it's not Elder Scrolls related, but it's Dunes related.
Hey, ESO Muster.
Hey, I was just whispering him in game. I was telling him that the YouTube's going great because of the 1080p, 60 frames per second. You can't beat that.
Yeah, I'll make an account next week, so whatever, you all have my name, like, it matters. Like, you can make a very quick Google anyway, I don't really care.
Yeah. I'm ready whenever you are, so.
I'm just loading.
Good.
I'm on the load screen.
Well, then let's, Oh, we are both so dumb.
Happy Friday, ESO Muster.
We're supposed to be in the public test server. Quit the game. And you're going to need to create a Nightblade real quick.
He's a big metal Nord.
Because we're just going to do some exploring in there.
I gotta create a character right now.
It'll take 2 seconds. It doesn't
really
matter what it looks
fully.
Like. And I just...
I want to make it ugly.
I'm an idiot. I forgot we were going into Imperial City today.
Oh, man. All right. Let's see.
Yes. YouTube is much smoother and allows full 1080p 60 frames per second streaming, which is a huge plus.
It needs to stop trying to make Google Plus happen. It's not going to happen.
All right, well, I'm just going to get right into it. Hello, and welcome to Dudes in Tamriel, episode 27. I am Scary Drew, and here with me is Scary Dew.
You started a little too early because my computer is not having it, so...
I apologize.
I'm stuck right now.
I'm so sorry.
I tried to quit the game, and the game said no.
Well, you weren't kidding over there.
How old are you?
Did you try alt-tabbing?
Yeah, that's why I'm on a black screen instead of a stuck... green in the game.
Dudes in the Sopranos. Black screen.
Spoiler alert. You haven't watched that one. Or heard about it at least.
So, I'll just continue talking while you get...
Yeah.
Did you control alt delete? Wait, why are you looking at me like that?
Because it's a goofy ass question.
Well, I see that you hadn't because you just did now and it
worked. I tried before and I've got this black screen.
Yeah, I mean, just, you know where to go from there.
I think we might need to start this one over. I'm completely stuck. I'm probably about to crash. No, let's see.
It's just your
what
game.
What the hell, ESO?
Yeah,
what?
It's just the game. It'll crash the game out, but your Skype should stay up and everything, so that should be fine.
Yeah,
you know
everything
what?
Else is up. I just...
You know what this
I
has
had
gone?
No warning.
The streaming gods hate us. The podcast gods hate us, because
it
everything else,
work.
I finally got everything working fine using OBS now and using YouTube now, and so I'm like, finally, no more technical issues. And so what happens? The technical issues jump to your computer, and Elder Scrolls won't work right.
I honestly, ain't nobody said they were ready.
Well, you know, when you click 5,000 times,
wait, what?
That's usually something that doesn't help your cause.
Wait, what?
I said when you're clicking 1,000 times, that usually is something that doesn't help your cause.
Because I'm in the screen. I'm clicking through the
was. I know. I did see. I was just.
You know, the
crap.
Part where everybody.
I know. I was just.
Because you have to.
I was just being a dork.
You watched the logo go through. I'm going to keep going. And now I have to agree to codes of conduct.
I need to figure out how to get out of here. It's over this way.
There's the door. Don't let it hit you on the ass.
Okay, so while you're loading up, since you got the game open now, all I need you to do is create a character and put make it a Nightblade?
No, I have to put my access code in because, again,
for the PTS, yeah.
Yeah,
I'm really sorry. I totally forgot we were going to be in the PTS today.
You
so
definitely should have confirmed I was ready to start the show.
Well, there's plenty of time because I have plenty of things to say while you're doing that. I just apologize for the hassle. I really do. I'm sorry. That sucks.
It's fine. Hold on. Or, no, hold on. Talk. You're fine. I'm distracted. I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. I'm sorry. I should have helped you get this all set. Not helped you, like, you can't do it yourself, but, like, I should have.
Should have waited before
I
you said hello!
Well, I should have. I could always do it again. It's not the first time I've
done
it twice.
That's what I tried to say, but you're like, no. Now you accept it. Now that I'm close to being in there.
Hello!
Hello!
So, I forgot what I was going to say. I forgot what I was going to say. So, anyways, we'll just go ahead and talk about the PTS real quick. That's where we're going to be today. using OBS now, streaming on YouTube, which seems to be working a lot smoother. I feel bad. ESO Muster, which is... I feel bad because I'm sorry. I'm stumbling all over my words right now.
Hello.
No, he sent me an email earlier, and I was going to read it on the show. And then as I was talking about him, it reminded me of that. So I'm trying to pull it up at the same time as talk, and it just distracted the shit out of me. So that was a bad idea. But for later. But anyway,
did you see what ESO Muster just said?
What?
That his kid just yelled the word ass. And I told him to teach his kid the word peach instead.
Or maybe wear headphones when you're watching an explicit show.
Yeah. Kids. So, hey, he didn't blame us. He was just putting it out there. So I'm on a load.
I feel a little bad because he was just saying the other day on his show that he's using XSplit and, of course, Podomatic, you know? And he just signed up for the paid license for XSplit. And this was like a few days before I said, screw XSplit. I'm done with XSplit. And so, to be fair, OBS is somewhat more tricky to get working, less GUI user friendly, although the newer version isn't too bad. But
what am I supposed to make again?
You're making a Nightblade. Make sure it's in the Ebonheart pack. Make it look like or whatever. Name it whatever you want.
What
it doesn't matter.
Should this thing be?
I'm sorry, what?
What race should this thing be?
It doesn't matter, but you can make it make it whatever. The thing you need to do is in the top left corner, there's going to be a drop down where you can select V14 Ebon.
I see that now.
Which you're going to probably have to reset Nightblade because I think that changes it for some stupid reason.
I haven't even done Nightblade yet. I'm trying to...
Oh, well, good. There you go. But the good news is that... is that I actually just had my XSplit 3-month license renew like 2 days before I dropped it for OBS. So I'm in the same boat. I just wasted $15, but that's okay.
You can't get that back. Way to go.
Yeah, I could probably
email
customer support.
But both of your boats are, or both of the boats that you're in are your fault though.
And Mike's saying, go Bosmer. I agree. That is what mine is. I am a Bosmer. I am wearing the costume Valenwood Spinner. Classic Bosmer outfit here. And I look awesome. And this is what I always wear on my main, unless I'm in PvP. In PvP, they actually require your, for that guild, they require the, where's my guild tabard? Oh, for the costume. Yeah, there we go. They require this color schema at the dye station. It's like a teal, dark teal, and it's closer to blue, but whatever. And white, and then the guild tabber for Sly's Wolf Pack. So it's got a wolf on it. Shout out to Wicked Wolf. There you go. You should join this PvP guild because it's a wolf pack. So, anyways, but when I'm not PvPing with the guild, showing the colors, I throw on the Valenwood Spinner outfit. There's also the Wood Elf Vanguard, but this one I think just kind of looks a little dorky, and I don't really like it as much. Although this one you can see the wood textures on my character's skin, which I love having a wood elf with wood textured skin. That's why I did that. I thought that was kind of funny.
I'm almost done. I'm sorry.
No worries. So, anyways, we're on OBS now. We're on YouTube now, and the... I will say Dew's news. I finally made a website. We have a website now. Holler!
Holler!
We are at, of course, dewsandtamriel.com. So you can now find us on dewsandtamriel.com. I was telling Knight's Knight earlier on Twitter, this thing ended up way more BAMF than I ever anticipated it would be.
Not RAMF, but hi RAMF!
No, BAMF. Badass mother blanker. I know we're explicit show. I don't know why I said blank. it's fantastic. It has all the podcasts on there. It has the RSS feed. It's not the same feed as on Podomatic. So I canceled that subscription, but it still allows me to put as many as 2 episodes on there. So I deleted all the other episodes except for the 2 most recent, and then I'll delete episode 25 when I go to upload this one. And I'll keep that up for a week or two just so people know if they're getting the podcast through Podomatic and they don't watch the live stream or check out the YouTubes, then hashtag ESO Muster.
I'm really sorry. I was going to be a lot more enthusiastic about that whole announcement, but I was busy making a character.
I can make the announcement again.
No, I'm really sorry. Like, I wanted to talk about it. I'm so excited. Like, the website looks amazing. You guys,
it's fantastic.
It's www. dudesintamriel.com.
Call now.
Do I need to spell out dudes in Tamriel? I'm just kidding. So I'm on a low screen. But no, I am really excited. It looks really good.
Yeah. And regarding the RSS feed, for some reason, iTunes is taking its sweet ass time to update the thumbnail, which we have a new logo and I love it. It is very basic, but it looks fantastic. You'll see part of it on the top of the stream.
Why am I naked?
Because you have gear in bags. So
I want to wear a consumer.
The heavy armor, does it say heavy armor?
I have heavy armaments back.
Yeah, that's fine. Open that up, grab some stuff out of there, just throw on a bunch of heavy armor just so you have survivability in case we get attacked or something. But the idea is, actually throw on all light armor. I'm so sorry.
Oh, okay.
I'm sorry.
This is well planned.
I know, I'm really sorry. Well, because the idea is what we're going to do is explore Imperial City a little bit, and there's a lot of really, like, hardcore enemies there, both players and NPCs. I was dabbling around in there yesterday, and let me just say, it's no fucking joke in there, okay?
Do not go in
unprepared. It is...
Oh, like a cool friend cat.
Oh my god.
What?
Scary Doo has logged on with I.
No, it's A LMAO.
Whatever. A. That's not how the English language works.
Yeah, I tried to just do it without the second A, but somebody already took it because somebody's hilarious. So,
So all you're going to do is you're going to hit C. You're going to put all your points into Magicka.
C.
Or put 20 into Magicka and then the rest into health because that's enough Magicka for me.
Holy crap, how many
W, double W, full stop.
That means I'm putting 42 into health. Are you
yes,
sure?
that's fine.
Okay. And then where's my weapon? What weapon should I use?
Use a destruction staff and a restoration staff, which should be in your weapons bag or whatever. I don't know exactly. It's not really important. Mostly what's important is getting, because we're not planning on doing any combat per se.
Mm-hmm.
The important thing is to, on your skills.
Yes.
If you go to shadow.
You're a shadow.
You
want to pick up, sorry.
Shadowy disguise and morph it to dark cloak?
Yeah, I don't have that.
Under shadow, the very top skill.
I have shadow cloak.
Shadow cloak, I'm sorry. Shadowy disguise is the other morph.
Shadowy disguise is a goofy ass name.
Well, get dark cloak.
Hold on, now calm down.
I know.
Oh my gosh, this is awkward. Press 1 to use the, you know what?
I'm sorry.
Okay, so I'm sorry, morph shadow cloak.
It doesn't really
matter.
Shadowy
disguise?
Yeah, dark cloak or whatever. It doesn't really matter,
actually. You want shadowy disguise, am I right?
Dark cloak.
What were you saying about shadowy disguise?
I thought that was the name of the base skill.
But that's the name of the... Okay.
I thought that was the name... I was like, you know what I mean.
I actually don't. All right, what else? What other skills do I need here?
Really, the only other thing you're going to need to worry about is light armor. Put all the points into all the passives.
Okay.
And that's really it. So you just need you need that shadowy disguise on your bar, on both bards if you plan on switching weapons at all. Because what we're going to do is we're going to pop that over and over again, which is why you're putting your points into light armor so that you have tons of Magicka.
I've lost
it. And essentially at that point, you can cast shadowy disguise or whatever it is, dark cloak, pretty much consistently with never running out of Magicka, which means you can run by enemies within 2 feet of them at all times and just keep casting it and then...
Okie dokie. Anything
ever get...
else I need?
What?
Anything else I need?
No, that's it. Just hit L. Head. And on the second tab, campaigns.
LMAO.
Hey.
Campaigns.
Right click Hatteras and set to home.
Hatteras. Home. Accept. This is a great episode.
And then you want to join that campaign by double clicking on it.
We have way too many announcements for people to sit here listening to me freaking set this up.
Oh, and we forgot wine.
I didn't forget one. It says solo access available expires.
Yeah, you want to enter? Oh, hit in, I said.
Okay. Now what?
Hit the check mark next to where it says you can enter Cyrodiil.
Well, Shoot Your Eye Out wants to be my friend, so I'm accepting that. Hi, Shoot Your Eye Out. She has good puns. Oh, Slags is here. Hey, Slags.
Hey, Slags is finally here. Have you seen the website, Slags? It looks amazing.
Probably got Yaga. Yeah, Slags, have you seen the website? Because you're even mentioned on part of it.
Okay, let me know when you get into Cyrodiil.
I will. Right now I'm on Cyrodiil load screen.
All
right.
Well, while you're loading, I will continue talking about the website. So, the RSS feed. iTunes has taken forever to update to the new logo with the thumbnail. It's basically just white print, basic white print. Sketch of a loot. And then underneath that in block letters, it says Dews and Tamriel or outlined block letters.
Dews and Tamriel are in Cyrodiil on the PTS.
There you are. Okay, so what you're going to do is you're going to come to this Transitus Shrine.
Look how big I am compared to you. I forgot you're a tiny little
wood elf.
I made the biggest Khajiit I could, but I forgot you're in the little midget wood elf.
Yeah, I'm a little tiny wood elf.
That's even better.
So,
so we activate this shrine
here.
Oh,
you got to be kidding me.
What's wrong?
Somebody disconnected the link. So, okay. You see how there's like a pentagon of the green lines?
Nope.
Okay, we're in the top right corner.
What?
We're in the... you have to use the Transitus Shrine. I'm sorry.
Oh.
And then you'll see the green kind of pentagon.
Yes, now I see it.
Yeah,
wow.
The bottom left corner there is a keep. It looks like a castle. It's Arius Keep.
Yeah.
Go ahead and click on that.
The bottom what corner?
Hold on, I'll just come over real
quick. Oh, I found it.
Never mind. Click on Arius Keep.
Dang, calm down.
I'm sorry.
I just didn't hear where you said it was.
So, normally, we're supposed to have access to the keep that's a little bit closer, but this one's pretty close to the entrance anyways, to Chalmun. Frickin' AD, are you kidding me? Who comes into the PTS? What a dick move. Like, seriously, AD, you're a bunch of dicks, and I hope that you get destroyed in everything you do, because that's bullcrap. They took our resources so you can't travel to Chalmun Keep, which is like the only point of the PTS right now is to go into Imperial City and test it out for the devs. And so somebody decided to be a jackass, go take the resources for what? I bet you they're going to take that keep too, so we don't have all our home keeps and remove access to Imperial City. I was wondering if anybody was going to do that troll dick move, and sure enough, somebody has.
Of course they would.
Why would you go into the PTS and then try your best to prevent anybody from testing the one thing that the PTS is there to test? I'm sorry.
Why wouldn't you be a troll? Why can't I get on a mount, I guess?
I am so sorry. You don't have a mount.
It's okay.
We'll run there. It's okay. It's going to take
a
while.
It's okay. I've got long cat legs.
It's okay because the time it takes us to run there is going to be the time it takes to talk about the website and stuff like that. So
the .com.
Yeah. Okay. So what I was saying was...
We froze poor ESO Muster's laptop, apparently.
Sorry about that.
ESO Muster. Blame Squarespace if it's the website.
I blame the fact that you're not using a beast computer I blame. We need to go this way. I'm sorry. Trying to figure out where the heck we're going. Boy, that's terrible. Mary Dominion.
My tail is blowing in the wind.
You know, I shouldn't blame the AD because you can create these template characters. So somebody might be normally in the Ebonheart Pact or the Daggerfall Covenant and then just create a template like you just did. So I don't know if it's people who are normally in AD, but whoever it is, dick move for sure.
Maybe they wanted to try a dick move in the PTS without doing it for real. I'm just kidding.
I love you.
I love you too. That was a dismissive I love you, and that's okay.
It was not a dismissive I love you. I didn't hear you because I was looking over at the chat, so I just figured I'd say I love you. But,
poor Slug still hasn't been to the website because his PC's still out of commission till Windows 7 or Windows 10.
I don't know how bad your computer is that it's having all these issues. Where did you go?
I'm coming.
Oh, I see.
I had to read the chat. I don't have to.
No, I'm sorry. I didn't. I thought.
I feel like we all know exactly what Slags did to make his computer all screwed up.
Fair enough.
Just what every.
Stay off those websites, buddy. They're not good for your computer or for your health.
Yeah. Get.
So iTunes is taking forever to update the. Although I haven't checked it in the past like 8 hours, but you know, I updated the thumbnail on the RSS feed for, you know, that's the image that when you pull up your, you know, the podcast, it's the, you know, the image that's there.
Hey, Slags, don't be a grandpa. You can look at it on mobile.
I know, right? Don't you have a smartphone?
Or Slags going to be like, I'm poor. I put everything into being able to watch Deuce and Tamriel and feel terrible. I cannot afford the smartphone. I have an old Nokia brick.
Mike says, dick move on PTS. What did you expect?
I know.
I expected people to properly test the servers. Oh, well, I'll get to that in a minute. I just got to remember.
Hey, LMAO.
So anyways, what I'm saying is that the old feed now only has episode 25 and 26 on there. And the new feed, even if it doesn't have the new logo, that's the big indicator. If it's a black logo with the white loot sketch and the white Deuce and Tamriel, you're set. That's the new one, that you're good to go.
Yeah, don't feel bad if you didn't get to make the logo. I didn't either.
Yeah, iTunes on the new feed still has the old logo. So the key is if there's only two episodes, you have the wrong RSS feed. You can actually go to the website. I put a link at the bottom of the website for the RSS feed. You can copy the link location, you know, and then punch it in manually if you need to. But it is on iTunes. So if you're using iTunes, you can go there and get the correct feed. Just look for the one that has all the episodes. And then also Stitcher. I submitted the request to add the new RSS feed to our Stitcher page. I know we have a few Stitcher listeners. I just found that out recently. So you're going to have to hold tight on that. But if I believe if you're using the Stitcher app, you can, again, manually put in the RSS feed, which can be found on doozandtamriel.com. It's doozandtamriel.com/dooz-in-tamriel-podcast.
Oh, my God. Go and click the link.
%format=RSS. So
why would anybody just now click the link?
I don't know. I just thought if I could say it, then somebody might pause and write it down, you know, while they're listening. I didn't think
they
that was such a
bad
thing
to do. Just go to
Deuce. We need to head north here. So, what I love...
Go to the About Us page. It's fun.
It's funny. I did that this morning. So it's got our videos on there, on the videos page of the Cooking with Deuce and Tamriel, as well as the Alcohol by Volume special with Knight's Knight we did a while back while drinking.
We need to do another one for sure.
Absolutely. And then it also has a video of Dew and I ziplining through Redwoods, which is a fantastically awesome video. You should definitely check that out.
You should definitely see the end of it because...
It's fantastic.
His butt hits things. Oh, and did you already say that the Jack and Coke balloon?
Oh yes, I forgot about that. Yes, the Jack and Coke balloon challenge is on there.
And I'll thank Slags for that.
You can horrifyingly see me. It's gonna scar you for life. Is all I'm trying to say. Don't watch it if you want to.
Does your butt still burn from the Jack Daniels? Does it?
And then on the podcast page, you can now download the podcast directly from our webpage if you don't want to use the RSS feed or a podcast player or whatever you may be using.
Yeah, and you can click the freaking link instead of us having to tell you a long URL.
Yeah, exactly. And so that's going to be on doozandtamriel.com/dooz-in. I'm just kidding. It is on that page.
You're like.
You just take off the format=RSS at the end, but it is on that page. Okay, so.
You're like doozandtamriel.com/mygirlfriend. Is annoying slash dot. Okay, go ahead.
You'll see on the map here, these are the three sewer entrances. You can actually use the enemy entrances to the sewers, from what I understand, because I thought that the sewer entrances, like the sewers themselves, were going to be PvE. That proved to be false as I was sneaking around the Daggerfall sewers last night with my shadow cloak, and it was a lot of fun because nobody saw me because of the shadow cloak, obviously.
I have to open the crown store and buy this.
Oh, so they fixed that, huh?
Mm-hmm. It says locked content.
Yeah, because it gave me it automatically, but it gives you 5,500 crowns.
Yes,
so.
It does, so I am purchasing the bundle in the PTS.
There you go.
Confirm. Now I have gained access to Imperial City. So, sorry, I guess I could have stuck longer on that nifty little error message there.
So while we load the Imperial sewers here, I'll just finish wrapping up about the website. So you can.
It's awesome.
It is. You can download the show directly now. It's got the Twitter feed for the Deuce and Tamriel Twitter at the bottom in the footer. And it also on the homepage has the most recent episode. The YouTube is embedded, and
it should meet all your doodle needs in one place. All your Deuce and Tamriel needs, one stop shop.
Well, and this is one of the coolest things about using the website and using YouTube now, is that I can embed the YouTube video of the live stream now onto our homepage. So if you go to the homepage right now, you can actually, well, not right now if you're listening to the recording, but if you go while we're streaming Fridays after, you know, between what, 7 and 9-ish Eastern time, you can actually catch the stream there. And then after the show, I'll change that to the uploaded video of the stream. So then it'll always have the most recent episode right there on the homepage as a YouTube video. So that covers the website. I'm very excited about it. It looks fantastic. It looks way better than I thought it would. I got everything up and running better than I thought I would. It has features that I didn't expect to find. Like I said, like being able to embed the live stream right on the homepage. That's a huge, awesome factor.
Before we jump, on the count of three, we're going to say Knights was right.
Yes.
One, two, three. Knights was right.
He told me months ago to switch from Podomatic to Squarespace.
He told us on like
a and create my own website. And I was like, I don't feel like putting that much effort into it, you know? And
you're like, no, this is fun.
Well, little did I know I would have the website fully complete within 2 days. So
yeah, and it was effort, but it was like effort that would have gone to actual work. So it was fun.
I'm sorry, I was on the vape.
Oh, you're fine. You didn't knock it over. I'm proud.
So let's jump right into the Imperial City news. It is on the PTS, which is where we are here. You will find in
sewers.
In your sewers, I'll show on the map here. Here's the entryway. Now, this is an instanced area right here. All of this right here, this top right area, that is PvE. It's not even really PvE. It's a safe zone. So you're perfectly safe here. No enemies, no NPCs, nothing. Everything else that's kind of the darker shade of yellow here, that's all the PvP sewers with a lot of bosses and stuff like that. So you'll see over here there's crafting stations over here. What is that? That's that's the Telvar. We kept calling them Telvani on the last episode. They're Telvar stones. Then if you go to the crafting stations here, this is where you're going to see over here under the style, you'll see the new Zivkin is right there, one charcoal of remorse, and then the glass takes one
charcoal.
Malachite.
Sorry, real quick. Yep, sorry. Slags missed the name of the website because his quote shit crashed.
It's very intuitively done.
Yeah, I tried. It's also on the stream video. I'm looking at it right now.
It's on the description of the stream.
Yeah, I tried to. ESO Muster had the same problem. So you can't comment web addresses in YouTube chat. Apparently, it thinks it's spam. It told me to remove web addresses. So
well, that's good to know.
It's doozandtamriel.com/slags is a big old perfect like Sal Malexia's dumb flat Hank Hill looking peach. It's doozandtamriel.com.
Yes, it is. So, anyways, you actually can see here. You get a little bit of an image of what these items are going to look like. And the glass, actually, this glass looks badass. Now, I didn't look at it before. This looks badass. Yeah. I might make all my sets in glass armor.
I can't see it. I got to look at the stream.
If you come to this crafting station.
Okay. I want to see.
Just make sure that have items and have knowledge are not selected.
Oh, okay.
And then under style, go. It's the third from the last one. It's glass armor.
Hold on. Wait, I want to create, you said?
Yeah, under creation. And then change the style to almost at the end.
Uh-huh.
And then you'll see a little tiny, you know how it says...
Because I have no malachite.
Yes, but you see, like, on iron axe, is that what you're looking at?
What?
The item that it creates in the middle of your screen, where it shows the details of it.
Yeah, it says iron cuirass.
Oh, because you're on the armor. Yeah, the cuirass.
Cuirass.
And just above that, you'll see a little tiny image of it. It's like a little thumbnail of it.
Ooh, that does look cool.
Yeah, and then if you go to the axe, you'll see it's kind of like an eagle's wing or an angel wing for the axe blade.
Yeah, these look nice. I want this stuff.
Glass is very awesome. They brought it in because it was in Skyrim and I think Oblivion as well. Very popular style. The Zivkin looks all right, too, but I actually prefer the glass way more. So, speaking of the glass armor, these are actually going to be coming from the crafting writs. And thank God for that, because with the provisioning giving you Sigic Ambrosia recipe parts, and now once this update comes out later this month, I'm sorry, it's not August yet. At the end of August,
there's a Khajiit again.
You're going to have to do the clothing, leatherworking, blacksmithing, I'm sorry, clothing, woodworking, and blacksmithing writs to get the pieces of the style motif for glass armor. So that's how you get the glass armor. At least that's what I read. So we'll see. Obviously, things are subject to change when the update actually comes out. But that's what should be how it works, is that you get your glass armor. It'll be like the Dwemer motifs, where you get it in pieces. You get it in chapters or whatever. And so you'll have a chance to get one of those in every time you do one of the three crafting writs. So that's how the glass armor works, and it looks actually pretty cool from the little bit that I can see. So that's where you craft that, is in these crafting stations. I don't know if that's just Zivkin, or if you have to also be here for the glass armor as well, because I know Zivkin can only be crafted in Imperial City / the sewers.
You know what? Fucking YouTube just told me to take a break and try again because I typed fast. I'm sorry. That's rude.
Well, it can be annoying, but at the same time, I have no clue how to actually moderate the Twitch stream if we get, like, spammers in there. So at least it's got some modicum of automation to that.
Yeah, except in however many
episodes. Maybe a little overzealous, but
we've never had that problem. So. Yeah, and people on YouTube are way bigger douches, so.
Yeah, so.
Anyway, I had said, Mr. ESO Mr., I'm sure your website is beautiful, and I'll have to check it out.
Oh, yeah, he's got a nice website.
Yeah. I haven't seen it. Mm-hmm. He was saying that he's jealous of ours.
I could tell you some things that I did.
Presumptuous? I'm just kidding.
No, everything I did was really basic. I'm actually pretty good with that kind of stuff. I should actually dabble with that more often, but... let's go ahead and move along here. We're going to go down this hallway here. Now this
Black says you look like a hitman in that picture with the suit. You totally do.
I look like a BAMF is what I look like.
You look pretty cute
so,
there.
So here's where you're going to use your Telvar stones. The Telvar stones are going to be dropping from everything you do. Telvar stones. They're going to drop from everything you kill, everything you loot, everything you do, repair all my gear. And you can use them to buy these armor boxes or weapon boxes, but we all know how that goes. That's usually not the best way to do it if there's an alternative option. And there is. Up here, this guy here, he's going to sell you the actual items themselves. So here's the Telvar store, and you can see here there's Guards of the Shieldbreaker, so there's a Shieldbreaker set. Powerful Assault, cast an assault ability, up to 4 nearby allies gain weapon and spell damage. Reactive Girdle, that's stamina and health when affected by stun immobile. Anyways, there's plenty of websites that are already posting all of these that are available, all the sets, the new sets here. So I'm not going to read through all of them, but it looks like they're actually going to be in the Zivkin style, it kind of looks like. So plan for that. That helmet looks awesome, by the way. Hat of the Phoenix. That looks freaking awesome. So that's where you'll use your Telvar stones. When I was testing it out yesterday, I found that you do lose one Telvar stone if you die to an NPC, so be aware of that. And, of course, you lose all of them. Currently, you lose all of them, I believe, if you get killed by a player. I don't know that 100%.
It's like Grand Theft Auto.
Mm-hmm. But I'm pretty sure that's what happens there. I didn't plan this well because I meant to bring a lower level character in here, which I will do in a little bit to see if the battle level applies, because I still wanted to test that out, where it boosts your stats to max level or near max level, you know?
Hey, look. This guy has lots of faces now. Look, one of them's a
king. I'm not even near you. I ran off.
I'm back to... I'm. What's the mask with the two faces?
Oh, the mask. Oh, the Mask of Cheerful Slaughter. That's
well, we're standing back to back, so now he's got a Khajiit face in the back. I did that for fun. I'm sorry.
Wait, hold on. I'm rotating to get the. Oh,
not really that good. I had it better before, but I actually.
No, I'm sorry. I should have. Yeah.
It's not your fault. It really was my fault. I moved.
It's all right. So okay.
I have nothing of value to contribute, so I've got to put my Khajiit face on things. It's like a real cat.
So other than those main things, the crafting stations where you can create the Zivkin and glass armor and the Telvar vendors over here on the right of the map, the left side of the map has, just the sewer entrance, and then there's a bank, it looks like.
Don't read the cat.
Just normal things.
Read the chat.
Anyways, so let's go ahead and ignore that and move along. I'm going the right way. Here we go.
So see if you're just listening to the podcast and not watching the video, after the fact, you won't know that they said that Drew looks like a young Howie Mandel in that picture.
Thanks for telling everybody now.
You're welcome.
So we're going to go into the Harina Hypogeum. That is actually the name of the sewers themselves, the Harina Hypogeum.
Woo, we're diving into some sewers.
So now what you're going to want to do, Doodle, is you're going to want to crouch.
Okay.
And anytime we get near any enemies... Oh, here's a bug, by the way. It randomly sticks you into first-person mode, I found. So I don't know what the deal with that is. If you zoom in a little bit, it seems to correct that problem. So it's only if you're zoomed out all the way. For some reason, it's glitchy.
I'm not having that issue. What are you talking about?
When you're zoomed out all the way, it happens. It seems to correct it if you just zoom in a little bit. Not 100%
No, not happening to me.
It just, well, it, yeah, no, it's it only happens at certain parts, so, you know, it might later. While we're sneaking around, just pop that shadowy cloak whenever we get near any enemies. And the dark cloak, the one skill that you have. Yeah, it should be your number one.
It is.
Okay, yeah, so you're just going to want to cast that whenever we get near any enemies so we can just run by them and do a little exploration.
Can't I cast it now? Or
yeah,
will it
you
not
can cast
stay?
It now. While you're sneaking around, though, it does take your stamina, so just make sure you keep an eye on your stamina bar and make sure it doesn't run out. If it does, we'll find. Well, you because you don't need to be crouching to use the dark cloak. So if you run out of stamina, just pop your dark cloak till we run to a safe spot, and then dark cloak lasts about 2 to 3 seconds. So just cast it every 2 to 3 seconds to not pop out of stealth. NPCs are easy to avoid because even if you do pop out of stealth, they may attack you, but then you just pop it again and then run away from them and keep popping it. So that's pretty easy.
Pop it like
now,
it ought.
I don't know if this is for the PTS or not, but the White Gold Tower dungeon is right here, right at the very beginning of the sewers. Which doesn't.
Well, that wasn't a very long sewer.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense to me.
I want to wait and poop for longer, goddammit.
Well, this isn't Imperial City itself. It's technically the center of Imperial City, but for some reason, the White Gold Tower is right here. We're not going to go in there. Because that's a four-man dungeon, but we'll go ahead and come back here. So
you're only a tiny little woodman and a cat.
So I don't plan. I don't know if they plan to move that entrance location or if that's where they put it. It doesn't exactly make sense being right there, but maybe I'm missing something. So I don't know. So let's go ahead and move on down the sewers here. And so you'll see on the map, we're going to look for the ladder to either the Arena District or the Memorial District. Really doesn't matter. It looks like the Arena District comes first, so we're just going to go straight to that one.
Okay.
And now it looks pretty empty and boring right now. Okay, there's sewers. It looks cool and everything.
Not enough slug water.
Well, you're very quickly
not radioactive.
You're very quickly going to run into enemies down here, NPCs.
Oh, no.
And like I said, the other factions can come in here, so you may end up finding them in here as well. Not necessarily, but it does happen. Like I said, I was in the Daggerfall Covenant sewers yesterday, and I was watching them kill bosses and stuff, and obviously me by myself wasn't going to try and gank anybody, especially because I'm in light armor and I'm terrible at PvP.
You're a tiny little wood person.
But the idea is that you can, in fact, go in there and disrupt somebody trying to kill a boss, which is, obviously that's fun, and that's one of the appeals of this setup.
Didn't somebody do that to you? I thought that happened.
No, what happened was I saw somebody, they were by themselves, they were killing a boss, or not even a boss, it was just an NPC they were killing, and they had almost no health left, and all I had to do was just, like, peg them with my staff or whatever, and I could have still taken the kill from the NPC, but then the NPC killed him, and I was like, I should have cast a spell at him or something.
Cast spells at him.
Up here you're going to see, this is, there's some dead NPCs here that have been killed, but this is where you start seeing some of the NPCs. Looks like there's a couple over here. Here's a scamp over here. We're not going to kill them because you have no skills. We're just going to go ahead and see how I'm popping this dark cloak.
You have no skills!
See how I'm popping this dark cloak over here and just, just keep doing that and keep an eye on your magicka. Make sure it doesn't run out. And then just cast it every couple seconds. And then you can walk right by these guys. No problem. Come down this sewer right here.
Say so.
Mm-hmm. Just keep casting it. See, yeah, you got to cast it before it runs out, though.
Yeah, well, I would like to know when it runs out, but I don't know.
About 2 seconds. Two and a half seconds. So if you cast it every... mine lasts 3 seconds, but... Yeah. You can just cast it every second. Just boom,
so.
Cast it. Boom,
cast it. I'm trying to hit W. Oops.
Boom, cast it. That quickly, you can cast it. You should have more than enough magicka and magicka regeneration that you can cast it a ton like that and not
you
have
would
any
think
issues.
So, but I can't even crouch right now, so calm the hell down.
Oh, I'm so... No, no, I was just explaining it.
No, why can't I crouch?
Hit escape a couple times. It might be that glitch. Obviously, there are a lot of glitches in the PTS. I was sneaking, undetected, hidden, and somebody one-shot me with a flying blade. So that was fun. And then I asked in zone chat, I was like, how was someone able to target me with a flying blade when I was undetected and hidden?
Yeah, I can't crouch and I can't cast anything.
Well, shit. You can try logging out and log back in. PTS. I don't mind waiting. It might,
way to go, PTS.
It might throw you back to the entrance of the sewers. If it does, I'll just come back and get you. There's plenty to talk about, so it's no rush. We'll get through it. We may not have enough time to check out every district of Imperial City, and there's so many mobs you got to be shadow cloaking your way through the whole thing. So, you know, we'll do our best to give everybody an idea of what everything looks like. But
Flags is talking about somebody getting pregnant. I don't even know who that is. I don't care, because why can't I crouch?
There you go.
Wait. Shoot your eye out online. So I'm logging out.
You know, I do have to say, I'm getting 93 ping. I'm getting 90 frames per second while streaming in 1080p, 60 frames per second. So
I'm getting 93 ping pong.
So I'm actually pretty excited about that. That's pretty good. I like that. I sense your presence. Okay, so...
Okay, I'm coming back in, hopefully. So, life's hard when you can't crouch, and your Khajiit has cool claws.
And we're right next to the entrance, too. Imperial City, when we climb that ladder, you're going to see it's going to spit us out at that safe zone that they talked about that's at the raised vantage point, and it certainly is a pretty cool raised vantage point. You can look down and kind of see the action going on down there. While I'm waiting for you, I do want to say that next... Ooh, I gotta... Let me confirm the time on this.
Okay, now I'm hidden, so...
I'm
magically hidden again.
Lumi the Lock.
And oh my god, look what happened.
What?
I'm in some desolate plane.
Yeah, I saw that happen to somebody else and they posted it on Twitter.
That's cool.
And I don't... Oh, crap, there's a boss coming towards me. These are wandering
okay, so
bosses.
I'm going to log out and back in, I guess.
These are some of those you can see right there. Boom. That's Thrasitan the Undying. And those are those... I forget what they call them. Sweeper bosses. That's one of those sweeper bosses that almost just caught me from behind and just destroyed my face.
I'm sorry, I have to log out and back in because I'm experiencing things that happen in the PTS.
Well, go ahead and PTS. Do that. I'm just going to carry on for now.
Yeah, it's good. I came in crouching. I was like, perfect. And then suddenly desolate hell.
Yeah, because I'm concerned that you log back in and you're still there.
I will find out.
So if that's the case, then I'll come back and get you. We'll have you just travel to me or whatever, leave Cyrodiil, and then I'll come back and get you from that point.
I took two screenshots because it was cool.
Yeah, put those on Twitter. Or on the website now. Yeah, we can put them on the website.
Oh my god, a screenshots page.
What?
I said a screenshots page of all of your parkour instances.
Yeah, I was thinking of actually doing that, like just a, I don't know, like an...
Yep, I'm still there.
Like an info section or something.
Can I travel to you? What am I supposed to do?
Try to? I don't think you can.
Let's find out. Nope, I'm gonna have to
Type slash stuck.
Really? What?
Yeah, that's how. Yeah, that's.
What is this for? What happens when you get stuck between rocks or some crap?
Yes, and or in like.
They charge me gold.
Yes, they do, but you have 100,000 gold free.
No, I know. I just feel like.
No, I get what you're saying. If you're stuck because of poor game design, they shouldn't punish you for it. Yeah.
Dumb.
Well, the reason they do is so that people don't abuse the slash stuck when they're not actually stuck.
Yeah, but what if
to use it as a free
I want my gold back. It says moving to a safe location. We'll see about that, because... Alright, I got a load screen.
Well, I'm on a load screen as well, because I already
I'm
came
here.
Up to Imperial City. And I lied, it doesn't put you at that raised vantage point. That's just where you respawn if you die. So I'm going to go back down here.
Slag says if I'm a Khajiit, I can only crouch over a litter box. True story.
God damn it.
Unless you're our Khajiit sissy, and then you'll just crouch wherever the hell you feel like it.
So
but lately it's been a litter box.
Because it was Lumi the Lock.
I feel like your lack of response there was because you were focused on something less important, because that was hilarious.
It's not necessarily less or more important, but it is an announcement type of thing. So let me switch to the dude's account.
Jokes. Wait, what are we doing?
I don't even think I told you about this. This was just,
Do I need to do anything?
Are you back in the game?
Yeah, I told you. I'm stuck on the load screen
getting back into the sewers, so I'll come back and get you in just a second. Actually, let me just do a slash duck, and then it'll throw me right where you're at, too. Okay, so, Lumi the Lock, I don't know if any of you know him, he's pretty active in the community, blah, blah, blah. He is in contact with Zoss, with, Jessica, I believe, Folsom. And what he's trying to do is he's in contact with Deltia, Aloha Windy, Quest Gaming Network, the Dungeon Crawler Network, and I don't know if there's a few others or whatever, but he's trying to get anybody in the media community for Elder Scrolls to kind of get the word out that he's trying to set up a stress test event, which I'm going to try and be a part of that on, I believe he said Wednesday, so let me just see. Yes, he said test lag shooting for Wednesday around 8 p.m. CST, which is Central Standard Time. So what's that? 9 o'clock Eastern, I believe?
The time zone no one cares about.
I know, right?
Just kidding.
So, because Mountain is like...
Wait, what time did he say it was at?
8 p.m.
So it's 9 o'clock Eastern.
Yeah, 9 Eastern and 6 Pacific. And it looks like we're going to be doing it in the Memorial Gardens in Imperial City. So the idea is to get everybody from three different factions into the... let me do the slash duck real quick. Into the Memorial Gardens in Imperial City and do all of the skills that lag the server real bad and try to crash the server, because when you do that in the PTS, it allows Zoss to take all that data and then sift through it and make improvements. So essentially you want to try and break the game so they know what broke and then they can work on fixing it.
What broke is that I got left in purgatory doing squatting around as a damn Khajiit. Don't need to get a bunch of people together to know.
So if anybody wants to be a part of helping Zoss get this patch right, get this DLC right, join us at, again, that's 9 o'clock Eastern on Wednesday in the Memorial Gardens. It's not necessarily set in stone. He's still talking with Zoss about it and getting the details worked out, but... that should be essentially the idea there, and so hopefully we can get everybody from, you know, Deltia's crew, Crest Gaming Network, Dungeon Crawler Network, Aloha, all of them, get everybody together, get a whole bunch of people in there and really test it out. So, okay, I'm back here with you so we
Hi.
Can come over here and then head back into the sewers.
Well, this has been fun. This is really weird.
So, some other interesting changes coming. I don't know if this is coming with Imperial City, but one of the things they said that they were going to work on, and I think they said it at QuakeCon, but it was part that I missed. But what I do know is they are going to make some improvements to the group finder system, and I don't know what those improvements are. And I will say this, last weekend, I leveled up my Orc Sorcerer. Scary
Sorcerer.
And I actually did Fungal Grotto on there, and I had another character I was leveling up that I also did Fungal Grotto, and I used the Looking for Group tool. So it's not broken so much as it is very inefficient, because I had to sit and quest while sitting in. In fact, I quested so long at one point that I forgot I was even in the group finder, and I was like, what the hell? Why am I suddenly in a group? Well, because it finally found me a group. Now, as the Sorc, I am... tanking, so like, you know, I know in World of Warcraft, the Looking for Group tool, if you were a DPS, you were going to be sitting for 20 minutes because there's tons of DPS, there's very few healers and tanks. So if you're a healer or a tank in World of Warcraft, you jump right into a group because there's tons of group waiting for a tank and waiting for a healer. As a tank, I would have expected to jump into a group right away. So I think that it is broke in the sense that it should be finding a group a lot quicker than that. It may be that not enough people at max level for, like, the, in vet rank levels are using the Looking for Group tool. Because, again, this is when level 15 doing Fungal Grotto at level 15. So, you know, it may just be a result of a lot of low-level new players are using the Look for Group tool. But it
I have
work.
A suggestion for how they should do it.
Yes.
I think that they should make you all write embarrassing personal ads. And then you guys choose each other
to be
on
fair,
the basis of tank for healer.
To be fair, they
I like long walks in the grotto.
They do have use your dark cloak to get past these enemies over here again.
I'm almost out of stamina. I need to wait.
Okay, yeah, good call. Good call.
Thank you.
I'm almost out of stamina.
What?
Technically, you don't need the stamina. You can just stand up and use the shadow cloak.
Yeah, but I'm not fast.
But it's a little bit of a safety net too. If you leave shadow cloak, you're still at least crouching. You know.
Yeah, I can't do both that well at the same time.
So.
But anyway, I stand by what I said. Tank for healer. Like long walks in the grotto. Like
that's adorable.
I like killing bosses. You know.
Killing in the rain.
We need to write songs.
Long kills on the beach.
Long kills on the beach. Yes.
See how often I'm casting it? Just boom, one after another. You'll see your magicka. If it gets low, you're probably almost past all the enemies anyways.
Okay.
So just watch out in this corridor, because that's where that other boss almost freaking nailed me from behind. So he may be wandering around down this little corridor here.
That boss probably likes freaking pina coladas.
I'm moving a little bit faster than you because I have more passives put in to increase my movement speed.
Are we good here?
Yeah. You should be good. If you see an enemy, like I said, even if they start attacking you, just pop that dark cloak and run away.
Wait, Mike says, looking for a lusty Argonian for knights on the beach in heels. That,
that's
yeah,
great. That's great.
I didn't have
that's
the
perfect.
Creativity.
I love it.
That's exactly right. I like that. A lusty Argonian maid.
So, World of Warcraft actually has a very similar system to that, in that you do put in what you're looking for, and then, oh, interesting. The dwarven spear there following that guy, shooting a beam at him. Anyways, here's the entrance to Imperial City we're coming up on right up here. You can see the ladder leading up into the sunlight up above.
These are the cleanest sewers I've ever lived in, am I right? Just kidding.
And right into the arena district. And I'm actually glad we came here because I want to give a demonstration of this. And oh, I wanted to test something too. So you're going to have to come with me, obviously. But
where are you?
So, I just went up the ladder.
Thank you. This?
No, it's in the middle with the light shining down. Yeah.
I see it now.
And what was I saying before that?
Oh, you were going to give a demonstration.
Oh, the looking for group tool. So, yeah, it does appear to work. It did take about a half hour each time I used it to actually get a group. But, hey, I found a group. And, you're probably better off using Zone Chat. But if you're going to be questing anyways and you don't feel like sitting in Zone Chat, just throw on the looking for group, go do your questing, and then, hey, you never know. You may, minutes later, suddenly find yourself in both
with
groups.
A lusty Argonian maid.
Both groups went fairly flawlessly. I mean, we ran right through Fungal Grotto with no issues, and it worked out great for me. So, but they're looking to make improvements, so hopefully that means it'll get even better. And like I said, it's not perfect, so... You okay?
Oh, yeah, I was looking for you, but then I found you.
Oh. Loaded faster than me for some reason, but...
what?
Now, let's go ahead and get killed here.
Oh, okay.
Because I want to
show
good where...
At that.
Where it respawns you, so we're just going to run into these guys here, and you'll see they can kill you pretty quick. So, yeah. Now, don't do anything yet. Let's see. So you want to release, so hit R. Now, here's where you're going to respawn at when you die, and this is that raised vantage point they were talking about where you can look down.
Let's see. Thank God I don't have to crawl around. It makes me out of breath in real life.
Now, when I was here yesterday, there was a whole bunch of action going on below. There was enemy players. There was players killing the NPCs and blah, 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 blah.
There are an unsettling amount of chains and hooks coming from
the sea. Well, that's the plane meld. That's coming from... That's actually Cold Harbor merging with Nirn here.
That's right.
So that's actually from Cold Harbor. That's not part of Imperial City. That's the plane meld.
I see the dark anchor up there.
Yeah, the dark anchor above the White War Tower. The main dark anchor in this game. And pop your shadow cloak as you drop down because there is enemies everywhere down here.
Oops.
That's okay, there you go. Okay, there we go. Now just keep popping it as we run through here. So this is just one district here.
Are you going to stop saying popping it anytime soon?
No. Popping, locking.
It's making me think of pocket like it's hot.
Okay, and then I'll show you. You can get like right up next to enemies here, and they won't see you as long as you keep popping it and don't let it come off. So you just let it come off.
I didn't mean to.
I know. No, I was just saying that was a perfect example. Just keep casting it. Keep casting it.
I'm trying.
There you go.
I don't have any magicka left almost.
Oh, I'm sorry. Come over here. If you die, it's okay. We're right next to where we jumped off anyways. I'm going to peg him. And then.
Thank you. I don't have enough magic. Okay, I think I'm almost... Sorry.
You can save your magicka, get away from him. This is actually a boss, so this is like the worst person to be running from.
Okay, I think I'm good here.
Okay, just wait there.
Oh no, I'm getting detected. Oh my god. Oh,
it's alright, I got you covered.
Do you?
Yeah, just sorry. Okay, he doesn't see us. You're good. He's wandering on his own now.
Now I'm okay.
Alright. I'm sorry, dude.
Oh, it's not your fault. I didn't pop it enough.
Or you popped it too much. You said your magicka was gone.
Okay,
let's go. I
can't pop it.
I'm very familiar with this because I got like through some quests fairly quickly by doing this, so I didn't have to kill all the enemies along the way.
Well, your character
as a Nightblade.
Your character is always a sneaky little bastard from the one time there was that glitch where you could go way too fast.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think it was a glitch.
Yeah, it was a glitch. It was that the 5-set bonus for the Night Silence set allows you to ignore the movement penalty for sneaking, so you move at regular speed when you're sneaking. On top of that, the passive for vampirism also increased your sneaking speed. Those were not meant to stack with each other. And so when you had both of those, plus there's a Nightblade skill called Concealed Weapon, and if you morph it the right way, I'm sorry, right there, Concealed Weapon is the morph that, when slotted, increase your stealth movement speed by 25%. I was literally moving as fast as horses with maxed out speed while I was sneaking, which was awesome.
It was hilarious. You were like passing horses.
It was awesome, but it obviously was not working as intended, so they changed that. So here is the arena. Try and enter here.
Okay.
You'll see this gate over here on your left in the middle.
I will when I get there.
And anybody watching the stream here, you're going to see this is the solo arena they were talking about.
Wait, where am I looking? To the left here?
There you go. Okay. Oh, good, good, good. You can do multiple players in here. That is awesome. That is what I wanted to know. So now let's go ahead and show how hard these things are to kill by yourself, because this is supposed to be a solo arena. Now, to be fair, I am...
Should I help kill a thing?
If you can. You don't really have any skills.
I don't have any skills. I'm just going to crouch here.
That's fine. Well, you can go ahead and die with me.
How rude!
Because otherwise I'm going to die and you're still going to be in here, because I am not going to beat this thing. And then he's going to summon some more of his friends and everything.
Why are we finding a friggin' dinosaur?
It's... So those are very hard to kill. It is good to know that you can bring in multiple people. I didn't know if that was the case because they said it was a solo arena. It's designed for solo play, but if you want, you can bring other people in for help. So that's I'm pretty sure that's the solo arena. It's in the arena district. It's called the arena. And so that's what that is. You got the Orgrimmar, whatever their name is, Orgrim or whatever up there, and cheering, you know, what look like minions of Cold Harbor. And then down comes the Devourer there, and that's the first boss. And I think there's, what, 4 or 5 bosses in this arena? So go ahead and hit R to release.
Okay, hold on. Sorry, I got distracted by Slugs in the chat because he sent me my outro, and then he accidentally giggled himself, I think, a bit there.
God damn it.
You know how Slugs does.
A little bit here. By the way, your Khajiit looks awesome, just to let you know.
Yeah, because my Khajiit is massive and cool.
Okay, so that about covers most of this here. If you want to try and follow me, well, I'm going to try and find there was a...
Do I have to crouch?
Yeah, you're going to have to sneak past everything.
Oh, no.
There is a... there's a set crafting station, and now I don't know where it's at. Oh, you know what? Go ahead and hit /stuck. Because this is another thing I wanted to show that I didn't...
I can only use /stuck every hour. Please try again in 45 minutes.
Let me do it again, and I can't escape now, so I apologize.
Oh, dear.
If you go back down into the sewers...
Oh, you say that like I know where I'm going.
If you open your map...
Okay.
It's gonna be...
Sewer entrance?
Let me come... Yeah. So okay. Just run over to that without dying. And oh, you know what? I'm still here. You're good.
Okay.
Come down. Can you go down here? Ebonheart Pack Base. There we go. You want to come down here? Yeah, this is the easy way to do it.
Ah.
So when you die, if you want to go right back to the very entrance of the sewers, that's where you go. Is from that up that raised vantage point, you can go back down, not into the sewers where you entered Imperial City, or at least not where we entered Imperial City. And the reason for that is this... Well, as soon as the load screen disappears, I'll give it a minute here.
Slag says he needs yogurt. Yogurt.
Imperial sewers. So, almost done. Come on. Well, what you're going to find is that in the main entrance to the sewers there, when you first enter them, there's actually going to be 6, 7, 8 ladders or something like that. So you actually don't have to go... Here we go. You don't have to go through the sewer system
and get all stinky
and reach one of the entrances, like the ladder to the arena district, and then wander around Imperial City to get to each of the districts. If you want to jump right to the temple district, boom, there's the temple district. There's the Arboretum. There is the Arena District. There's the Memorial District. There is the Elven Gardens District. And now what this is doing, come up to the Elven Gardens District, find the ladder that says that. Or you don't have to if you don't want to, but
I'm trying to find something separate.
Yeah, go for it. I'm just gonna show
wait,
where
what am I looking for?
Elven Gardens. It really
I'm right here. Climb it?
Yes. And another load screen. Well, that's fun.
This is the load screen episode. Mm-hmm.
And actually, I emailed myself some show notes for once. Because there was a couple things I didn't want to forget.
We're already into the show.
I know, and we talked about almost all of it. I think all of it, I just wanted to double check to see if I, in fact, missed anything that I had written down. New website. Imperial City, sewers are PvP, cross-faction group finder. Oh, I didn't say that. The group finder, they are making improvements to the group finder. And one of the, I don't know what the specific improvements are, because they said this separate from the improvements they're going to make. Okay, here we are in the Elven District. So each district is going to have that raised vantage point where you respawn from, because each district is instanced. So you're going to have PvP going on in each district, and if you die, there's going to be this safe zone on this raised vantage point for each one, and that's where you come out for each of those ladders in that starting sewer area. So you can actually access each district very quickly and easily, which is nice. I don't think you can see, because you can control these districts. If you take there's three of the districts that you can control as an alliance. If you control that district, I don't know if you can use this now. You probably still can, but I'm not 100% on that. So, the group finder, they're making improvements to the group finder. And one of those improvements that, again, like I said, they said this separate. They said we're making improvements and doing this. They're gonna introduce cross-faction group finder dungeons. Now, from what I understand, and this would make the most sense, it's only going to apply to 4-man group dungeons, your fungal grottos, your imperial cities, your city of ash. You know, all those 4-man group content is going to be cross-faction if you use the looking for group tool. So it doesn't mean you can group up with someone from another faction, I don't think, and then join a 4-man dungeon. It's only for the looking for group tool. I don't know if that's coming with Imperial City. I think that's just something that's coming in the future after Imperial City, the quote-unquote beyond from Imperial City and beyond at QuakeCon, which there wasn't much of beyond.
I still think people need to just write creative personals ads and call it a day.
Oh, well, that's what I was saying is World of Warcraft has that, and that's one of the things I do want to see.
Personals ads?
Almost. You put in, I'm a healer, this and that, here's my gear, stuff like that, and it allows you to put a message in when you're looking for a group, or if you already have a group and are looking for another member of a group for your group, you can put in what you're looking for. You know, we're looking for specifically a Templar healer, you know?
Chuck a box and plug it in and... with certain skill set or something.
Well, yeah, but you can be more specific than that, too.
That's what I mean by skill set.
Yeah. Well, like, not just your skill set, but like I said, if you're looking for someone with specific types of gear, or
for
whatever
reason.
If you're
looking for a character with a big butt.
You know, or like you're doing for a trials group, you say must have, you know, this skill and this skill. You know, because that happens a lot. Like, what's the light armor one? Annulment.
Must be spontaneous.
You know, you must have annulment on your bar, you know, or something like that.
That's kind of what I meant as a general skill set, not the... I just meant it generally like that.
Oh, yeah, yeah. And that's what I'd like to see. I don't know if that's what they intend to do when they say they're making improvements, or if they just are going to improve the effectiveness and functionality of it. But... you know, that's something to look forward to, at least in the future.
Hey, when I hover over your name, it says Scary Drew Longshot Dragon Star Arena Champion.
Yeah, that is a title. If you hit C.
I want to know my title.
I don't know if you have any on the, since it's a template character.
Hey! Khajiit Nightblade.
So you'll see background, like it'll say your name, it'll say Khajiit Nightblade underneath
that.
Oh,
yeah, says, no title.
Yeah, title and then none and... yeah, you get that from completing normal mode in Dragon Star Arena.
Well, I did not know. Have fun.
I have Volunteer, Recruit, Tyro, Legionary, Veteran, Corporal, Sergeant, Pact Hero, Master Wizard, Fighters Guild, Victor, and Dragon Star Arena Champion. Those are my titles I've earned. And those are just kind of fun little things that, like, when you accomplish something, it gives you a title, and then you can put it on, and people can see it.
Yeah, it does look pretty cool. It's kind of show-offy. I like. It's kind of like you're like, that's Dr. Scary Drew Nightblade to you. I've worked very hard for this degree.
One thing I love about Imperial City here, you'll see this, do you?
I won't see this.
Look at all these siege weapons. These are NPC siege weapons.
That's awesome.
Yeah, they're NPCs that are attacking this wall here.
It's quite nice in here.
And that's actually pretty cool looking. Set up there. You can see a Zipkin hammer fist there in the background walking by.
yeah, I do.
What, giggity for the hammer fist?
No, he's just sauntering around.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. So, you're going to get a lot of wandering around mobs and obviously players. That's one thing I noticed is haven't really seen any players in here, but when I was here yesterday, it's probably because it's still too early in the day. I don't know. But, when I was here yesterday, it was like everywhere I went, there were brawls going on. And they said it on at QuakeCon, and Lumi the Lock was saying the same thing. And I told him, I agree 100%. It's really like a street brawl in this place. When you got a bunch of people running around, it's really fun as a Nightblade to use that dark cloak and run around hiding from people and just see all the action going on. It's a lot of fun to just kind of explore and watch the excitement go on, even if you're not actually taking part yourself.
Grim Jogo is here. Sorry, I said Jojo in the chat.
Grim Jogo was here yesterday when I was testing the stream. Welcome back.
I was about to ask if that was the person. Welcome back. Thanks for joining. This is a person. Is this the person who watches on YouTube?
Yeah, he said he's seen the videos on YouTube before. I don't know how many he's watched or not, but
why are you watching this garbage?
I know. I ask that every time somebody says they watch or listen to our show. I don't know why. I don't know what is wrong with you that you like our crap. But so, I think that's. Let me see if there's anything else I'm missing from my list.
My weapon looks cool up close.
Last motif from Crafting Ritz. Okay.
Oh, cool ass cookie.
So I'm going to go ahead and try to find... I'm going to go back down into the hub.
My cattail brings all the wood elves to the yard. And they're like... I don't have anything.
Okay, I'm going to go back down into the sewers here. And I'm going to try and find... because there was... if I can... there, first of all, there's a trophy room that I can't get into. It says you need at least 60 dark something. I forget what it's called. It's apparently an item that is new. I've never heard of it before.
I've never gotten a trophy in my life. Did you know that?
Really?
Yeah, I'm a big loser.
Mm.
Yeah.
And you're in the age of trophies for everyone.
I know. That's what I'm saying.
I'm going to buy you a Dew trophy.
You want to hear a story?
Best Dew in the world.
Oh! It's called a ring. That wasn't a hint. I'm not that kind of woman. We've already been talking about it. Do you want to hear a story?
Yeah.
I was in Brownies, which is the little girl form of Girl Scouts. It's like Cub Scouts for boys. And my troop was doing... well, we were going to be part of a parade. I forget. Just something downtown.
Yeah.
We were going to have a float. I helped work on it and everything, and I got a really bad flu the day of the parade, which I was very excited for, and I was only like 5 or something, maybe 6, and I couldn't go to the parade because I was so sick.
Yeah.
And the troop leader, the old troop leader, was my best friend's super amazing, nice mom. But then the new troop leader was this rude bitch. And she had trophies made for every girl. I don't even know why there were trophies for this. That's what I'm saying. She had little trophies made with their names and stuff and the troop information for every girl in the troop except for me. And she said I didn't get one because I didn't go to the parade. And I was like, but
oh,
I was.
That's messed up.
I was like, lady, that's my terrible. Mom was pissed.
What the hell is that all
That's
about?
Why I've never had a trophy. That would have been my one shot at a trophy because I'm not an athletic individual.
When I was in ROTC.
And people don't give out trophies for getting a bunch of A's unless you win a spelling bee. What?
When I was in ROTC in high school, I was part of the drill team.
That's a lot of letters.
Not the dumbass dance team that calls themselves the drill team because they stole that because the drill team has actually existed in the actual military for like, I don't know, a couple hundred years or something. So you can't just come in and do dance moves and call yourselves a drill team. Sorry.
I just feel like we're a little bit past the point where we can get judgmental about any kind of drill team. At least they move their bodies. I'm like,
fair enough. But we actually we didn't win, quote unquote. It was a scoring system out of 100. It was the standard drill with arms. Now you do with arms and without arms. One's where you carry the rifle and sometimes you get real fancy and do the spinning of the rifle.
The other's where you amputate your limbs. Sorry.
And then you also do drill with without arms where you're just marching. And then there's standard and then there's exhibition. Standard is where the hosting school will provide a set of drill maneuvers that you do, and you know, you have to execute them as well as you can. I'm in the Memorial District if you want to join me. You don't have to, though.
Oh, okay.
And then exhibition is where you, as the competitor, come up with your own set of drill movements. And I can't believe we didn't win the exhibition without arms. I don't think we competed with arms exhibition. We did the exhibition without arms, we did the standard without arms, and then we did the standard with arms. And we nailed the standard with arms, and then we also did something that most schools don't do. We did what's called a silent drill, and what that is you call one command. What are you laughing at over there?
Slugs called you Howie Mandel and Tamriel.
Telling a story here.
Sorry, I didn't mean to start laughing.
But our exhibition drill was a silent drill, which I don't think anybody else at that competition did because it's extremely difficult. It's about a 5-minute sequence.
Talking about silent love.
It's a 5-minute sequence, and it is all silent. You have a choreographed drill sequence.
My game just crashed. FYI,
I'm so sorry. I'm just going to go ahead and we're almost done with the show anyway, so go ahead and log back in. I'm just going to show this last little bit over here while I talk. And then,
I just wanted to let you know that I was logging back in.
Yeah, and then I'll find you after I go show this real quick. And then,
I'll do a cool Khajiit dance and have my tail sway.
So our exhibition was, you usually like get super bonus points for doing it silently, where, literally, I think it was like Cobra or something.
And then one kid farted.
And it was like Cobra March, you know, which isn't an actual drill command. It was our own custom one. And with that, we began a 5-minute long memorized sequence of drill maneuvers. And usually the fact that you have it memorized and you're doing it silently, whereas every other school is calling it command by command, you know, like left flank, march.
Oh my gosh,
right flank,
you're better.
March, you know, things like that.
I still stand by it would have been funny if some kid had, like, farted and it ruined the silent thing.
Well, it was outside.
That's
so
why
you
didn't
hear
win
it
the
anyways,
trophy.
But anyways, we didn't win the exhibition without arms for some reason. I don't know why. But we did, in fact, score a 98 out of 100 with the standard drill with arms. And they didn't announce us as the winner. They announced the homeschool as the winner.
Oh, no.
Because the homeschool also scored a 98. In fact, there was 4 schools out of about 20 that scored a 98.
Oh, no.
And there's no tiebreakers. So technically, all 4 schools won. Now,
Default it to... Oh, no.
Yeah. So they just, like... And it was actually our sergeant, our ROTC sergeant, the teacher who raised hell. He was like, excuse me, I'm looking at the scorecard. And I think I pointed out, too. I was like, We there's 4 teams that scored the highest score, and it was a score of 98, and we were one of them. Why did we not get at least acknowledged in some way? How do I get into the Memorial Armory? There's enemies in front of it. There's somebody pounding on the door. I don't know how to get in here. Okay, well, I'm going to try anyways, and wish me luck.
Good luck. Better luck than your awkward silent drill situation.
So yeah, so technically we did win, although it wasn't really a win, it was a tie, but that's all they do, so... and honestly, we were so dumb to die. Maybe I can respawn here and... No, there's a... Okay, well, you know what? I was hoping to show it, but it looks like I can't get into this freaking doorway because there's enemies here. But there's actually... This is a new crafting set. It is a 9-set... you have to have a 9-trait set. So you have to have 9 sets or 9 traits researched, and I didn't mean to hit that skill, damn it. I was on the wrong skill bar, so I'm going to try and get out of here, and there we go. Shadow cloak away. There we go. Running away, and I'm very fast with my shadow cloak. And here's this other door. Let me get out of combat here real quick, and there's DC. Here we go. Here's some action. Oh, and I'm going to die. They found me.
Can I ask real quick? Yeah. Grim Jogo in the chat says Imperial City looks huge. What is your opinion on that, dude?
It is.
Is it pretty huge?
Each one of these districts is pretty big in its own. You can actually, like,
it's pretty cool.
Right here, you can see this is the entire Memorial District. This is where you may have missed it, Grim Jogo, but I was saying earlier that Lumilock is setting up with some of the other podcasters and streamers and everything to do a stress test coming this coming up Wednesday at 9 Eastern, 4 Pacific. Nine Eastern, 6 Pacific, and we're all going to meet here.
It's some kind of time.
Yeah, we're all going to meet here in the Memorial District. All 3 factions to use as many, you know, lag causing skills as possible and try and break the server, so that way Zoss knows what broke and they can analyze the data and everything. But bring your puns. You can see here. This is the Memorial District. You can see it goes all the way back to that back wall over there. And this is just one of the 6 districts. And these districts circle the White Gold Tower in the middle. And you can't access that middle area. But they did say they will release that in, you know, I don't know, another year and a half or something. But it'll be a while. But eventually they will unlock that middle area. So yeah, this is just one of the districts, and this doesn't include the sewers. The sewers have bosses in them. Each district has bosses in them. There's quests. There's PvP. In my opinion, it's
hello.
It's worth the $25.
I didn't know I was right next to you.
Yes, I got killed, so I came back here.
I'm tall.
Because I couldn't get into. I just wanted to go in there to show the crafted armor set. It's a new set. But anyways, like I said, it's just a 9 trait set. So yeah, I don't know if it's necessarily worth $25. Because $25 is a little pricey for a DLC. It's on the high end. It's not, you know, it's not expansion prices, but it is pretty high end for DLC. DLCs are usually around $15. But you know what? With the PvP aspect, the PvE aspect, the new item sets, the new bosses, the new styles.
Yeah.
You know, you're really getting a lot for your $25. So.
This is the one that everyone's been looking so forward to, and the PvP and the PvE that I can see why they're charging that, because they're going to get the money.
And
people are going to pay it.
And with the caveat of lag, I can't wait to see this place when it's packed full of players, because based on what I've seen, look, there's an All Mary Dominion down there. I'm going to pet
it. Pandemonium.
Yeah, see, now you're getting hit by my staff, buddy.
That's awesome.
See? And you're just standing up here, and you can see enemies coming, and then, you know, like, it's really like a street ball. It's really fun. And this is just with the limited number of players who are, you know, helping out on the PTS, testing out. You know, look at my guild here. Look, Goshkia, 3 people, Wings of Fate, 2 people, ESOTR Meridia, 5 people, Undying Spirit, 3 people, Sly with the Wolfpack, 6 people. When I log back into the live server, those are going to have about 20 to 50 people in each guild. So most people are not in the PTS right now. They're just playing the normal game. I just jumped down on accident.
There's a Khajiit here. Ow.
And I'm going to go ahead and die again so that I can just get sent back up there.
Sorry, there's a couple of times where I haven't been close enough to my mic, so...
Oh. A little summon shape from the Zivkin Dreadweaver here. That's pretty cool.
What?
I don't know if I've seen an NPC summon a shape like that before.
Oh!
Yeah, it's a Nightblade skill where you summon... in fact, I can show you real quick, because I don't have it, but I can unlock it here.
Hi, Khajiit. There's a Khajiit here.
Right here. This is summon shade. Come look at... Oh, I need to be facing an enemy, because it casts it on an enemy.
I tried to let you on my lap, you annoying Khajiit, but then you scratched me.
Oh, it won't cast it because I'm up here. Oh, well.
Oh, goodness. I'm bumping my mic.
Oh, there it goes. I was just out of line of sight. See, there's my shade. See it? Standing
yes.
next to me? Yep, that's the summon shade, and that's what that NPC
that's
has
awesome.
Just done.
That's extremely cool.
Yeah.
Sorry, I have a Khajiit that's being held like a little baby. Can you see this?
Yeah, that's adorable.
Hi.
Well,
can you purr into the microphone?
Hello, it's me, Khajiit.
We should rename Sissy A. Alameo. Looks like an alien.
Grim Jogo is saying he's going to get the Dark Brotherhood DLC as well. I just want to give you. Oh boy, I'm just had a huge frames drop there for a second, but it's back now. Just a heads up, I don't think you're going to see the Dark Brotherhood anytime soon. They were talking.
But I
about,
have a hoodie.
You know, they're talking about quarterly DLC updates. So next is going to be Orsinium, and that's going to come. What, end of August is Imperial City, so end of September, October, end of November is going to be Orsinium in Hrothgar. So maybe after that you'll see Dark Brotherhood, but I think not the Dark Brotherhood. What's the other one? The Thieves Guild, maybe? No, because I think Dark Brotherhood is coming first. So yeah, you might see that around end of February.
I didn't know that was coming. I think I missed a big announcement.
Oh, they've been talking about it since last year's QuakeCon. They're going to introduce the Thieves Guild and the Dark Brotherhood.
Oh, I remember now. Well, that's awesome, because then my hoodie will be even more relevant to a game.
Nice slags. He did the Wii No with the hand emoji.
Look at this stupid tail that's in my face. In my face, it's a microphone. It's my new microphone. Why is your butt in my face?
So
sorry. real life Khajiit interaction.
One last thing I did want to say, which irritated a lot of people. Is,
oh boy.
I mean, I guess it should have and shouldn't have at the same time. They did say they are still working on removing the veteran ranks, which is good that they confirmed that's not off the table with the increase to Vet 16. They said they hope to have that done sometime next year. So that is not
odd.
Coming anytime soon. Odds are that's coming like in the second half of next year, in my opinion. I mean, anytime next year could mean it comes in January of next year. That might be, you know, it's still going to be a while, 5 months or whatever. But, you know, I mean, I don't think it's going to be coming at the beginning of next year. I think that's going to be like after June-ish, because they don't seem to be very close to finishing that project. But aside from that, I had one other thing and I don't remember what it was. Oh, I did want to say one last little note on the website before we wrap things up here, because that pretty much covers everything I know about Imperial City so far. So, you know, honestly, there's not a whole lot to Imperial City. It's just what it is, you know, hundreds of hours of fun, you know. So the basic setup and layout of the six districts, and yeah, there's different bosses and stuff. So if you get real in-depth, there's more to it, but for the most part, that's it, and that's all you need, because it, I mean, look down here. Look at all this action. There's DC fighting Ebonheart players while fighting NPCs down here. Do you see all this going
on
down there?
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. It's going to be a blast with a lot of people in here, like you said.
It is absolute mayhem in here. There's an
Aldmeri
Dominion. So there's another faction. There's an Aldmeri Dominion. There, DC looks like he died.
Pure and adult.
Ebonheart Pact and a Zivkin Dreadweaver all fighting each other right below us. That is fantastic.
That is pretty cool.
I mean, there's hours of fun just standing up at these vantage points and watching the fights below you. But I did want to say the last thing regarding the website and everything. Our logo, I thought about, like, I wanted to get a hoodie, which I need to do after the show. I need to order those hoodies. I'm going to have our
logo. For 105 degree weather.
I know, but, well, you know, for the winter. We're getting close to fall.
So we can hibernate.
I know.
I could do that in real life.
A black hoodie with our white logo. It looks awesome. Maybe I'm the only one who thinks that, but
it does look cool.
I love it. And so we're going to have those made for ourselves. I considered maybe like trying to set up something where we could sell them. The problem is I don't know how many people would buy them. You have to buy them in advance before, you know. And honestly,
look, Slags, if you want one, we'll just fucking order it and you can pay for the damn shipping.
Well, even better than that, what I'm going to let people do is go ahead and just download our damn logo. I'll put it on the website somewhere for download. You can just download the PNG file, and then you can.
I'm so lazy.
Because I mean, it's cheap. If you buy two, it's only $25 each. If you buy one, it's only $33 on the website. I was, in fact, let me real quick. Another thing that's coming with Imperial City. One of the updates is there's now an option to allow the game sounds to continue playing after you've alt-tabbed out, which helps with the stream, because I'm alt-tabbed now and you can still hear the game sounds, so that's nice. And I think I just lost the chat. I went to Google and it
ESO opened. Muster would buy a hoodie. I think that we should definitely distribute.
I would, but like to buy the hoodies, it's a couple hundred dollars to like get a very small stock of them, and I wouldn't know what.
You're not understanding how some of these websites work. You didn't run this past me. I can't help you.
Pre-orders, maybe.
No, I'll go over it with you later.
Okay, that's fine. Yeah, we can. Consider, we'll consider doing that. I don't know. Like, I'm not here to make money necessarily or anything.
I'm not here to
know,
make friends.
So, But
I'm not even talking about for a profit. I am definitely saying, like, either way, or like you said, we can just give people the PNG. Then they can put it on their like hot pink.
Like,
I am far
more concerned about having people in this world walking around in Dews and Tamriel hoodies than I am about actually selling them. So.
Slags, I tried to get him to agree to, because those websites will let you do all kind of custom clothing, and I think we should make you a pair of women's underwear what?
I like this idea.
Oh, yeah, a pair of women's underwear for Slags that say not Almalexia's Peach. Was that what I had said? Something like that. Yeah. I think that was it.
So the website...
Slags, I feel like you should take pictures and, you know, send those in. Sorry, that's all.
Oh, no, you're fine. The website you can go to is alliedshirts.com. And actually what I did is I just Googled custom hoodie. And it's the Google shop on the right side. It's not a link. It's a link, but it's not like one of the search results. It's just the on the right side where under shop on Google, there's Allied Shirts. And you'll see the hoodie is only $33. And I'm actually going to real quick, I'm gonna customize this real quick. And then I'm gonna
on the show.
Yeah, well, because I wanna just show it on the show real quick.
That's ridiculous.
Upload, choose file. It'll just take 2 seconds here. It's no big deal.
Yeah, it's not weird if we make our fans underwear, right? Slags, right? ESO Muster.
Okay, there we go. So, this will give people an idea of what it would look like if you use this website. I tried using another one that had like 5-star reviews, and it was not functioning the way I needed it to. So I was like, "Screw you! This is Zazzle.
There's Cafe Press. There's all of these."
Crap! I never started the recording. We're streaming, but I'm gonna have to. I don't know how I'm gonna manage this. Shit! Oh well. There's not gonna be an intro or an outro on this episode.
Can't you just download the? Never mind.
I think you can download the video from YouTube. I don't know if it loses any quality though, but I'll figure it out. My bad. Shit, that's. I feel like a fucking idiot. So here you go. Here is the. Right there on the stream, you can see the Dews and Tamriel hoodie. There it is.
So, what that hoodie says is. I've given up on life. Please don't interrupt me. I'm listening to things in my headphones.
Okay, so with that, I will start my loot. Let me turn up the vol a little bit.
The vol. I just want to say really fast that being on YouTube makes me a little uncomfortable because my recommended videos are all very, very, very strange. Because, you know, I watch those cookie decorating videos.
Yeah.
Okay, so, but then I don't know where these other ones come from. So I have Final Fantasy, A Realm Reborn, Episode 8, bees, it says, like the insects. And then How to Decorate a Rainbow Leopard Cake from Cookies, Cupcakes, and Cardio. And then Last Moment Alive, Hospice Wedding, Anne and John, August. What the hell? Why is it recommended? It says recommended for you, a hospice wedding. It's extremely strange. And then Elder Scrolls Lore, Chapter 24. That makes a little bit more sense. I don't know, and you know what, the cake, I understand. The Final Fantasy with the bees, I'm not sure. But the hospice wedding, I'm a little weirded out.
Hold on, I need to...
it's like... I like Grim Jogo's idea. What about a Dews and Tamriel Speedo? It actually says a Doors and Tamriel, which I think we should change our show name to.
I
love
that.
It.
That sounds hilarious.
And I think we should definitely get a Speedo. I love that idea.
You know what we need to do?
What?
We need to get the hell out of here because I'm getting a lot of background sounds.
Okay, well, Slags has a t-shirt that says he loves Slags, but nobody's surprised. So, all right, where are you?
Just go back down into the sewers from that upper area there, the little door in the ground.
I'm coming. I don't know where I'm going.
You need to die and... Because I said on that raised vantage.
I don't know how to die.
Just run into an enemy and let them kill you.
Okay, I'm doing it.
And then once you're dead, just release, and then there should be the little the latch.
You said down somewhere. There's no.
Yeah, you go down into the sewers because the entrance is in the ground. It's
You said down, like the expected direction I would go would be down.
Yeah, it should be behind you.
I see.
Yeah, right there.
Yeah, by down I thought you might jump down.
And then I'll just do this load screen here, and there's no music or anything because I turned that down because. I think it's because the PTS, it's not muting all the other sound, like the music and everything when I slash loot like it's supposed to.
Oh, Lord.
Or maybe it just never has, and I just never been anywhere that noisy. There was just so much combat and everything going on. But anyways, slash loot.
I'll get there. When I get there.
Actually, I'm going to jump up on this thing because I like doing loot on top of way shrines and transit shrines.
As long as you can see me jumping, yep. Where are you?
I'm right here.
Can you see me?
Can you see? Yeah, I can. Can you see me up here?
I couldn't at first, but now I can.
Oh, there you go. So, I think that about wraps everything up. Do, what are your final thoughts?
I'm Khajiit drunk dancing, so that's cool. Tails, super cool. Final thoughts are, I'm liking the YouTube stream thing. We're kind of getting some kinks worked out. We had trouble yesterday getting the chat to not look stupid on there, but it's looking better, and I think that'll be something they fix down the road. Ramph just tweeted that he missed it. Yeah, Ramph, you just barely missed the end of the show, my friend. I'm super excited, actually, about the YouTube thing. Now we have our new friend, Grim Jogo, who's joined us because of it. So,
yes,
damn
welcome.
You, Twitch.
Welcome to the party.
Yeah, and thank you, Mike, for popping in and for our cool... front page background.
And painting.
Yeah, and the painting, of course.
Which are one and the same, but, you know.
Beautiful. Thank you, Slags. Thank you, ESO Muster. I do think that ESO Muster should get a Dews and Tamriel hoodie, and we should get an ESO Muster hoodie.
I like it.
It's going to be an ESO Mustard hoodie. Mustard.
I'm sorry. Yellow hoodie.
Yeah, it's gonna be mustard yellow, and I'm gonna eat it with a hot dog. Anyway, I'm sorry. I know Imperial City, public test server, all the things, DLC, blah, blah, blah. I'm so excited about the website. I love it. Drew did a great job. I literally contributed nothing.
That is not even.
Wait, no, I contributed taking a photograph of Mike's painting to use for the header that was better quality because he was using a stretched out pixelated version. That's what I did.
You provided the quote that I used on the About Us.
Well, but that wasn't on purpose. You saw it. I didn't even know you were going to use that, but I'm really glad you did. I absolutely love the website. I like how simple it is. Yes, I'm talking up our own website. If you don't like it, I don't care.
It's
go talk. Go complain
yourself.
To Slags. Send all your complaints to Slags. This is his department.
At Spider of Slags on Twitter. Yeah,
next time you're pissed off because we bitched about the Cinch Mount or whatever the hell, we do a rant episode, send it to Slags. I don't care. No, but I love the website. I think it's really cool. Everyone should check it out. And I feel like there was something else. Anyway, but especially Drew. I love you. You did a really great job. I'm really proud of you.
I love you too.
He did an awesome job. I'm super grateful because I did absolutely nothing. And also, I want to add that Brownies leader was rude and should have given me a trophy because I couldn't help getting sick. And I still helped with the float. And I was like 5. Okay.
That's even worse. I didn't know you were that young.
Yeah, because it's before Girl Scouts. It's Brownies.
Oh, I missed that part of the story.
Yeah.
Sorry.
No, it's not your fault. It's just like, what kind of sick person? But you know what? I'm sure that terrible karma has come to her, and she probably doesn't have any trophies either. They probably all burned down a house fire.
Somebody's streaking through me.
I saw that. Anyway, it's been really cool being a Khajiit and having a sweet tail. I'm not used to having a sweet tail. So yeah, anyway, I also, one last thing, I think our characters, your short little wood guy and my Khajiit, we stood next to each other by accident earlier, mm-hmm. And I was going to take a screenshot of our faces because it looked like a funny selfie, but I couldn't because you moved, so we need to take a selfie.
Oh yeah, we'll do that after the show.
Okay, that's my fast California girl talk, final thoughts.
My final thoughts, I'm really excited for Imperial City, way more than I was 2 weeks ago after finding out some of the details and now having gone in here and... seen what it'll be like. It's a lot of fun, and I've only just scratched the surface. I can't wait till I get into a PvP group in here with my guild and start wrecking shop all over Imperial City. It's so much fun. You know, there's NPCs in Cyrodiil, but everything is so spread out, you can easily avoid any NPCs other than the guards and the keeps or whatever, but in here, you can't. You cannot go around Imperial City and avoid the NPCs. So if you're going to be in there for PvP only, even if you have no intent of doing any of the PvE, you're going to have to kill mobs because they're there. They're everywhere, and that just creates a great aspect to the PvP aspect. And like I said earlier, it absolutely feels like a street brawl, which is so fantastic and fun. Out to Jessica Folsom. She had tweeted earlier that good news is her I think it was an MRI came back negative. She said, well, I don't want to say too much, but it was on Twitter, so that's kind of public. But you know, she said that the bad news is 3 years of suffering with something.
Aww.
That they, you know, and or three doctors, I think she might have said, not 3 years, I don't remember, but essentially that she still doesn't know what's up, but it's not, you know, the MRI came back negative, so I guess that's good, but at the same time, still no idea. So just wanted to send her our best wishes. She's one of the community managers for ESO. I'm pretty sure it said that Jess girl, and it looks like her. I'm almost 100% that's who that is. If it's a completely different Jessica, I'm so sorry. I just want to give that disclaimer. But like all the main Elder Scrolls people are following her and everything, so I'm almost 100%.
Oh my god, that'd be so creepy if you were like, congratulations on your MRI, random Jessica, who's not Jessica, and Jessica Folsom's like, what the hell?
I know. So maybe I apologize ahead of time if I'm way off on this, but whoever that was, are sending our dues wishes to you and wishing you all the best, and hopefully you figure out what's going on and recover from it. So I just wanted to throw that out there. Other than that, love our new website, dudesandtamriel.com. Check it out. Be sure to add the new RSS feed. If you only have two episodes on your RSS feed, that is the old one. Keep an eye out for the new black logo. But like I said earlier, iTunes still has the old logo on there, even though it's supposed to be updated. So the real key is if you see all the episodes on there, that is the correct RSS feed, and then you can get our podcast updated automatically, blah, 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 blah. And you can now download the show straight from our website. You can view the latest episode right on the homepage, and so on and so forth. And just like I said, I'm not here to make money, but I did just because, you know, if you're building a webpage, you might as well throw on a PayPal donate link. This will probably be the only time I ever mention it. I don't want to like ask for money. Like, it's, you know, it's not like I can't afford the website. So, and that's,
you can't.
At this point, that's the only cost now because OBS is free and YouTube is free. So, unless you
want him to sit on more balloons full of Jack and Coke, then send your money our way.
Fair enough.
Feel free to send it to my private PayPal. I don't have to let him know. I'm just kidding.
But yeah, there is a donate link at the bottom, as well as the iTunes link and the Stitcher link. But both of those, I believe, lead to the old feed. So I still need to update those, I think. Actually, the iTunes might be up. Sure, obviously, they haven't, like I said earlier, they haven't accepted the new stream yet. I'm sorry, the new feed.
No
yet.
One will be able to follow our indecisiveness here. I don't know. Maybe Stitcher.
So if you,
they said we should make lingerie and call it boobs and Tamriel. By the way.
Yeah, I saw.
Yeah, I just wanted to say that out loud because it's funny.
But yeah, and then the RSS link for the new RSS feed is also at the bottom of the homepage. Actually, it's on the bottom of every page. It's the footer. So if you're having trouble finding it, you can just, you know, copy the link location, paste it into TextPad or something, and then get it from there and just enter it in manually. So. Very excited for the new website. Very excited for the quality of YouTube. I do need to get in the habit of clicking to start recording because the old OBS actually has a setting where it automatically records your stream. The new version of OBS, the multi-platform version, works better. The sound is off on the microphones on the old one and it's not on the new one, but I couldn't find a setting to automatically record the stream and I forgot to click record, so I'm gonna have to figure that out. Worst case scenario, just it'll already be on YouTube because it auto saves to YouTube as a video once you're done with the stream. So
yeah, so just go watch the intro and outro separately.
Yeah,
like,
so
asshole.
Well, I mean, they're on YouTube, the intro and the outro.
I know,
so.
That's why I said that.
In fact, I added those as the very first entries for the podcast feed, so you can actually listen to them if you want to from the podcast.
Final thought.
Mm-hmm. And I think that's it. So thank you, everybody, for coming. Thank you, ESO Muster, Slags, Mike. I can't remember the other guy's name. Was it Chocobo?
Oh, my God. Because you can't scroll and chat.
Yeah, I can scroll now. I just had to alt-tab out.
Grim Jogo.
I am so sorry.
Jogo.
I am so sorry about that. Grim Jogo. Thank you so much for coming, everybody. And Ramp, sorry we missed you. Hi, Ramp.
Hi, Ramp.
Hi.
Where can you find us?
So if you want to find us, you can find us at dudesandtamriel.com.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it. Because
and twitter.com/dudesandtamriel, which
is
linked.
Oh, I need to fix the scrolling marquee at the bottom has the Gmail, and there's no space between that and the...
Yeah, it's bad, I know.
That's okay. Boom. It is now fixed. So
oh, wow.
Take that.
I could have told you that way earlier. I'm sorry. I thought... Ooh.
But yeah, everything is on the website at the very bottom. You can find the link to the YouTube, email, Twitter, everything. So no more long rambling, trying to remember all the places you can
find
us.
We're still doing it, though.
You can now find it. Well, it's the first time. From now on, I'll just say you can find us at dudesandtamriel.com.
And you can always mention the Twitter.
So. Yeah, at dudesandtamriel. It doesn't have our individual Twitter, so I guess I can say you can find us at dudesandtamriel or on Twitter. I am at scarydrew86.
I am at Smiter of Slags.
So no complaints, too.
I am at _burial. Oh, that's right. I am at _burials and not at Smiter of Slags. That's where you send the complaints.
I think that's it.
That's where I'm at. That's where you can find me.
All right. Dudesandtamriel.com. Everybody, check it out.
Right.
Have a good night, everybody.
Have a good night. Bye. Is it done? Is it over? Has the ship sailed? Have the tourists left? Did the battery run out? Did that worthless prick really kill a protected animal? Is this blancmange available in strawberry? Excuse me, Slugs. Sorry, but panna cotta is better, really. You had to pick that. Did you have to cut me off? Do objects in the rearview mirror really appear closer than they are? Will there ever be a sequel to Super Troopers? Do I use a carrot or a stick? How did you make out like it never happened and that we were nothing? Do! I added that part to do.
God damn it.
If it doesn't rub the lotion on its skin, does it get the hose again? Why are red-haired girls hot and red-haired men not? Again, Slags. I'm sorry. Where the hell did you put my... Although I don't even need your love, do you realize that when you treat me like a stranger that it feels so rough?
That's classic Slags.
Did you just walk in here with those muddy boots? Where do I sign my name? Is the beach crowded today? If we all apparently have good days and bad days, where the fuck are my good days at? Did you have to stoop so low and have your friends collect your records and then change your number? Sorry. Is Windows 7, how the fuck is blonde a hair dye thing? Is it really? Are ostriches really that aggressive? Can we tiptoe by the tulips? Do I not need that though? Are you now just somebody that I used to know? How does plagiarism really work? It's like I keep getting stuck on the damn song. Anyway, is it over? Is it done yet? He says he's going to wake up to a shit ton of notifications.
I saw that, and I think he's grossly overestimating how many people listen to this show.
Yeah, no, we don't have that many fans. Like, calm down. We're going to send you underwear. Don't worry about it. It's fine. Are we done? Is this thing off? Because I can't sing this song anymore. I mean, Slags, do you really have to, you know, stoop so low, whatever the fuck the That makes more sense. What's that guy's name? It's something French. Gautier or something like that. Gautier? Canberra? Is it off? Is it done?